before we start this movie review, I'd like to quickly apologize for not recording my other Michael J. Fox interview videos. I decided not to because I feel like I would run out of storage still. So I decided, okay, I'll release my movie reviews, and then maybe I'll release my other views, you know, later on, because I have stuff to do, you know? Besides YouTube, I got school, man. They're making us do an essay! God, why are they making me do this? Let's start the review. Mind. I never knew about Pete Davidson. I don't think anyone technically did until him and Ariana Grande like broke up and decided to call off their engagement and stuff. So this is when people were starting to know him. And then when he joined SNL and was under the wings of John Mulaney or Mulaney or however you want to pronounce it, people started to know him more. They kept calling him his adopted son, all that stuff, the next him, you know, everything like that. So when he made a movie about his life, I bet people were really excited. I don't know because I never really watched it when it came out because I was like, okay, it seems exciting, but I don't know if I have time to watch it. It's a movie about Pete's life. I mean, it is called The King of Staten Island because that's where Pete grew up. And we see his life in a way that I don't think he's ever talked about before. Because it is, keep in mind, this is actually based on his life. And they say that at the end of the movie, that the movie was in memory of his father, who was like a firefighter during 9/11. They even like show like, you know, all that stuff. And then his mom dates another firefighter who is the voice of the dad Frank in F is for Family. You might know him, Bill Purr. So I thought it was pretty funny that he was in the movie. I didn't know it was him with the mustache, you know? But besides all that, we're getting serious now because this movie, it seems pretty serious. It wants to be funny, yes. And that comes from the SNL thing Pete's been doing. But it can also be serious at the same time and show us things of how children are affected by their parents and all that stuff. I mean, my God, I found myself being like upset at some scenes. I was like, poor Pete, this must have been a hard life for him. But then he comes to terms with all kinds of stuff, and he ends up going to New York with his girlfriend, I think, and that's where the movie ends, which is what you saw in the beginning of the video. That is just perfect, and I want to see Pete doing more things. This is just fantastic. I want to see Pete do more movies after that. That was truly a beautiful movie. And you guys should watch it too. Please, go watch Pete's... Actually, Pete is in another movie that I will be reviewing next time. But still, you should just watch his movies and support this man and watch his SNL skits. I know we've all been seeing it everywhere with his Timothy Chalamet one with the skate, yeet, skate. But like, besides the other ones, you should watch when he was starting out. When he was under the wings of John Mulaney. When he was just technically still a nobody. And then watch him become Pete. It's just truly a really good movie. And you should watch it.